Okay, if I could welcome on stage Ron, thank you very much.
So I've done 41 presentations this year on this industry, on peer-to-peer finance, on marketplace lending, really having to explain what it is and how and why. And I'm not going to do that today. What I wanted to do today was really three things. Leave everybody with the 9 universal truths of every single platform that you are running or you're investing in or that are here today, called the necessary 9 for our industry. I want to tell people and show people why I cried last week about our industry and how I remembered why we're all doing this, and leave people with some thoughts for the future. So let's go ahead and start today's presentation. So here they are. Here are the 9 things that each of us have to do, and we have to do it right. Pricing, credit, and risk. We as platforms have to set a gross return, an expected default rate, minus our cost to give a net return to the lenders or investors. And when we rate and rank our borrowers, AA, A, B, C, D, E, and HR for Prosper, we have to make sure that the AA's yield less than the A's and the B's and the C's. It can't be a curve that doesn't work. It has to be as expected to show these investors what the pricing, credit, and risk is. Perhaps the most valuable part of all of these platforms is point number 1. Point number 2 is all about the data. We are literally big data companies with marketing people and risk people, but this is data. When we got to Prosper in January of 2013, to recreate Prosper, we realized we had to have a different API and more data and be transparent about it and share that data inside out. As an SC registered company, everything we do is public. And we give it to the academics at Berkeley, we give it to the Orchard guys, and everybody else in this industry. And we're constantly looking for new sources of data to validate identity, income, and employment. Big, big deal. Number 3, for each of these platforms, we must have a diversity of investors. What we learned in the financial crisis, they all correlate to one. They all go away on the very same day. So we as platforms need retail and institutional. And what Europe's learning is retail's fantastic and important, but these platforms cannot be just retail. To scale, to get to escape velocity, we must have a blend as platforms of retail and institutional. These investors aren't just with us or Zopa or Funding Circle or RateSetter or Lending Club. They're investing across all of our platforms. So we need to make sure we get to these investors, we have retail and institutional, and within institutional, we have permanent capital, funds with capital, funds raising capital, sovereign wealth funds, hedge funds, governments, and more. Because one day, these investors will find another shiny object to invest in. And we have to make sure we always have enough investors. And as important as number 3 is number 4, we must have a diversity of borrowers. When we got to Prosper in January of 13, we just had borrowers doing debt consolidation. But now we have borrowers doing large purchases, home improvement, medical, vacations, special events, taxes, second auto, solar panels. Lots of different types of borrowers, and entrepreneurs who want to borrow money for their small business. So diversity of borrowers and the types, but also how do we as platforms get to those borrowers? It can't just be direct mail, it can't just be SEO and PPC. We need partnerships and existing client marketing. We also must have something called CPA, cost per acquisition. We as platforms can't spend $1,000 to make $500. Even on volume, that's not going to work. For unit economics, we have to make sure every single loan, all of us as platforms we do, becomes profitable. Very, very important part. And you'll see as we mature as platforms as an industry, CPA and unit economics and marketing efficiency to get these borrowers become a much more important topic. This is it here. It was wrote about yesterday by Georgia. This ecosystem, the infrastructure and the rails between the investors and the platforms. If we invest in this, if we support the middleware, we will grow, we will scale as an investable asset class, as exchanges for credit. So working with the IRA custodians, the trust companies, the administrators, the leverage providers, the securitization firms, the accounting, tax, and audit firms, the leverage firms, it is important that we as platforms share and embrace the ecosystem and the rails between the two. It's really how we're going to go from $1.6 billion at Prosper this year to a lot, lot more next year. And my kids tell me, Dad, I'm not sitting down on the computer anymore. It's over. It's all on that mobile device. I don't want to do things the way you did. I don't want to buy music the way you did. I don't want to travel. I don't want to sit at a desk. So we need to have mobile applications to help borrowers come to us, to take pictures of the information we require, to easily validate and verify, and continue to communicate with our borrowers and our investors with these mobile applications. You'll see a lot of new mobile things coming in our industry, in particular from Prosper in the first quarter. We think this is the key to the big, big growth ahead is mobile. And number seven is safety and soundness. If we aren't safe as platforms, if something happens to one of us, we need to have a feeling of a special purpose vehicle that's bankruptcy remote, so if something happens to a platform, it's all there. And we need firms like Larry's, where is Larry? This guy right there, to be the backup servicer for us. So if something happens, the investors don't have platform risk, the borrowers don't have platform risk, they have this backup servicer and this vehicle that's safe from the bankruptcy courts, God forbid, something happens to one of these platforms. Number eight, existing client marketing. I called Zappos and I said, why are there three Zappos boxes on my doorstep every week? How is it that you're getting my wife and my daughter and my family to keep ordering stuff from Zappos? We as an industry need to copy existing client marketing. How do we make these borrowers or these real estate firms or these small businesses happy, loyal, willing to rate and rent us and tell their friends and do it again? Our cost per acquisition, the second time somebody borrows, zero. So that second, third, and fourth loan for all of us becomes critical to success, profitability, and continued growth. And number nine is trust and transparency. When Uber started, when Airbnb started, they had this issue. There wasn't trust between that driver and that person, or that person with a room and the person who owned a hotel room. We need to create trust and transparency like Uber and Airbnb, and we need this. This is the competition. We're not competing together against each other. We're not competing with the banks. Our competition is something we call EANU, and it's education, awareness, and understanding. These are the nine universal truths that will kind of set the table for today's conversations on the panels and the platforms. So what is it that made me cry last week about this industry? This video reminded me why I'm doing what I'm doing. So Prosper crossed $2 billion last week. It took 8 years to do $1 billion and 6 months to do the second $1 billion. So we sent a note out to our clients and said, tell us why. Why are you using us? And this is my favorite one.
I have since taken 3 loans from Prosper and paid off 2. I am extremely happy that Prosper has reached the $2 billion mark in loans issued through our platform. Notice I said ours. I am Prosper, and through Prosper, will prosper. Take care.
That's why we're doing something good here. Yes, we're trying to grow and make money and change the world, but we're helping real people. Thousands of videos are coming in and pictures of people who are sending pictures of themselves scuba diving, saying, I was underwater before Prosper. Or people showing home improvement or bikes or reunions and weddings. This is a good thing. We are trying to change the way people do things. So where are we going? There's asteroids that are going to come to the industry. It happened to Airbnb and Uber. They have regulatory scrutiny. We're going to have it too as an industry. We talked at breakfast. The more we communicate with the regulators in the UK and in Asia and Latin America and here in North America, the more they can see what we're doing, why we're doing it, and how we're doing it. It's not a question of if it will come. It's just when. So let's be prepared and transparent. There will be a public investment vehicle. The days of individuals going in and picking loans $25 a year and trying to outsmart all the platforms, there will be a publicly traded fund, maybe the AltFi Index, maybe something else, where people can invest in one CUSIP closed-end fund, open-end fund, mutual fund, registered fund. It's coming. At some point, we're not going to be cutting edge. We're not going to be new. We're going to just be the way. Like the way people travel, Uber. The way people rent, Zipcar. At some point, this is not going to be new. It's just going to be the best way to borrow. Efficiency, conversion, and activation. These are critical components for each of us. When we get a borrower, how do we activate them? How do we actually get them to go from listing to origination? These are critical things as we are big data companies to improve all of us on efficiency, conversion, and activation. You're starting to see gamification with Payoff and eHarmony and Match.com and using some of these new ways to do loans. And the First Real brand. Yes, one of these companies is going to go public. One's going to be in all states. One's going to be in all countries. We're all trying to create brands like Kleenex and Jacuzzi or Prosper. And more products and more types of borrowers. And clearly, we're going to be targeting different generations. If I could leave you with one more thing, it's this. It's not about counting how much Prosper is doing or how much you're doing or how much that one's doing. What we're doing here together is creating this shared experience and trying to create this huge pie. So let's not measure mine versus yours. Let's make this pie huge so there's tons to eat. Thank you very much. Have a great day.